activity really soon. There it is. Isabelle. K. Rool. Ice Climbers. Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Direct. We're just going straight into it, no character.
Hello, this is Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited, and this is the final Nintendo Direct before the launch of Super Smash Bros.
Let's go, Sakurai.
So far, we've confirmed 72 fighters, 74 if you count Pokemon Trainer as 3. Our entire team has worked really hard. With this Nintendo Direct, we'll have revealed every fighter you can find in the game.
Okay.
Okay, let's
do this. All right, so they're going to reveal every single fighter. So who's the first one? Incineroar. Oh, well. Oh, it's Ryu! Or not Ryu, Ken! It's Ken! And then it's going to be Incineroar. Ken turns up the heat. Let's go, Ken. Hadouken! Yes! Shoryuken! So he's Ryu's Echo Fighter, I presume? Because I don't think he's a new character. Alright, so here comes Incineroar then. Yep, there he is. Good job, Ryu. Or Ken. I keep going, getting them confused. KO. So here comes Incineroar. Yep. Fire. Incineroar enters the ring. So the Grinch leak was probably fake then. Well, on the bright side, it's not just these two. That was my only complaint with the other stuff. The reason why I wanted the Grinch League to be real. Because otherwise, it seemed like it would just be these two. And I didn't want that at all. Alright, Incineroar. Well, there goes Ken. K. Rool, Villager, and Bowser Jr. That was good. That's funny. So where are they going? There's Ken. There's Incineroar.
From the Street Fighter series, Ryu's rival Ken joins as an
so that's a similar icon, but it's
original game, Ken could be considered
different area. That's weird. It's a similar artwork, but different area.
Luigi is the original Echo Fighter. But let's get back
to perhaps Luigi's the original.
Ken has been distinguished from Ryu over the years, but the Ken you'll see this time is based on Super Street Fighter 2.
Mm-hmm.
Here's how he'll differ from Ryu. His heavy Shoryuken turns up the heat. The shape of his Hadouken is different too.
Hmm.
And his Tatsumaki Senpūgeku strikes opponents multiple
times. Oh, so I'll definitely be using
Hell Wheel.
I'll definitely be using Ken then.
Focus attack. We've included lots of Ken's signature moves, such as his famous kicks, which change based on your command.
So that image leak was real then.
He's a bit faster than Ryu, and we've also incorporated other tweaks from recent titles. Just like Ryu, he has two final smashes.
Nice.
First, the spinning uppercut.
Shinryuken.
We've made it look flashy, as it is in the first
Nice.
Series. Execute a final smash near an opponent, and you'll instead
Shippu-kyu-ryu. Okay, interesting. And then Incineroar.
Now for our last new challenger, Incineroar. It may be a Pokemon, but it mainly uses pro wrestling moves, and as such, its throws are a bit more powerful. Like a true pro wrestler, when one of its attacks is successful, it'll pose for the audience. Luckily, you can cancel out of these poses at any time, so they won't open you up to additional enemy attacks.
Final new challenger, huh?
This special is called Darkest Lariat. It was Incineroar's signature move in the Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon games. Perhaps it's something of a red cyclone. Its up special is Cross Chop. You'll leap up and come rocketing back down. This attack can be very effective, but if you mess up, it's easy to self-destruct, so be careful. For its side special, Incineroar makes opponents run the ropes after a dashing grab. When they bounce back your way, press the button at just the right moment. If you're too early, you'll do a back body drop. Wait too long, and you'll fail. Nail the timing, and you'll pull off a powerful lariat. Its down special is Revenge.
A counter.
When damaged, Incineroar's Burning Passion comes to the surface, powering up its next attack. That's Incineroar's idea of a counterattack. And its final smash? Max Malicious Moonsault. It's even faster and fiercer than the Z-move it's based on.
I'm gonna be real with you, this kinda stinks. So this is it?
We finally revealed all of the fighters you'll find in the game. This is the initial fighter selection.
Whoa, just the eight.
There aren't very many at first, but it is the same amount as the original Nintendo.
So just the starting eight.
And once you've unlocked them all. It'll look like this.
Cool.
It may seem hard to guess where each one's located, but they're sorted by number in the order they joined the series.
Okay.
I hope you'll enjoy battling with all 74 fighters on the roster.
All right, I'll admit, this stinks. Incineroar is our last character. That honestly does stink. A lot. But it's okay. DLC will get us pretty much everyone we want. But, man, no Shadow. We got K-Rool and Simon, though, but no Shadow. I'm sorry. I'm a little sad about that. Alright, so that was Amiibo, and then K-Rool and Ice Climbers.
We're creating Amiibo in parallel with the game.
Ken, Daisy, Pichu, Isabelle, Young Link. What about Snake? Is Snake in an Amiibo? Icons clash.
We determined that collectible trophies wouldn't be a great fit for this game.
Oh.
Honestly, they were really difficult to develop.
Oh.
That said, the Super Smash Bros. Series is one massive crossover at heart, and we want to create something more. A way to enjoy characters other than fighters from a variety of video game worlds.
Huh?
Here's what we came up with. They're called spirits.
Uh-oh. Here we go.
And I don't mean the spooky kind.
All right.
To put it simply, these spirit characters will lend a helping hand to your fighters, powering them up in battle.
I see.
In the Super Smash Bros. Series, the characters are toys in the real world, but they are fighters in the world of imagination. Returning to the real world is an ongoing theme. In the imagination, you can battle impossible combinations of characters. In this mysterious world, the unspeakable happens. Many beloved characters lose their physical forms. All of them, except the fighters, are turned into spirits, unable to return to the real world. This is a spirit. Fighters can join forces with spirits to enhance their powers.
So they're basically custom moves for fighters.
Wildly different spirits.
They're basically like stickers.
There are several classes of spirits. Standard spirits are dubbed novices. Stronger ones have the title advanced. Especially strong ones are called aces. And some are in a league of their own, legend. One primary spirit can be assigned at a time. A primary spirit's power will be added to the fighter who has it equipped.
Mm-hmm.
In some cases, these augmented fighters become extremely powerful.
So streamline custom moves, basically.
If
a primary spirit has enough available slots, you can assign them support spirits. While primary spirits enhance fighter stats, support spirits lend them additional skills. Once the primary spirit and support spirits are set, your fighter's all powered up.
Oops, sorry. So spirit battles.
The main way to acquire spirits is to win spirit battles. You'll find a variety of spirits lined up on the spirit board. Choose the one you want to battle for. When you do, you'll face off against a fighter whose abilities and personality are kinda sorta similar to the opposing spirit.
I see.
In the case of the Lakitu and Spiny spirit, you'll battle against Iggy Koopa in a group of small red Bowsers.
Huh.
Iggy's riding high in his Koopa Clown car, of course. Here are some examples of other battles you can expect.
Makes sense. Valley of Gordos appear out of nowhere. So you gotta find the DDDs and knock them out, pretty much. Invisible DDDs. Gutsman. Shows off the throwing skills. Alright. Owain. Taunting at every opportunity, killing Edge in hand. So that ain't good. Because that would really hurt. Don't you dare hit Isabel, you jerk. The Imprisoned. Gear him guards while the beast looms. So it's like fighting all these different battles here. Battle with a flower blooming on your head. Also, dress up as Lips so we know we got that costume coming. Three hedgehogs try to screw up victories with drills. You alright there, Simon? Hal Emmerich. Dr. Dodge is protected by a giant rod. Alright, I'm gonna be real with you guys. I think we've seen enough. I think we get the idea. Okay.
Even if you accidentally hit the shield, the damage will carry over, so you'll have an advantage the next time you encounter that spirit.
I see.
Primary spirits have strength based on their type. Attack is strong against grab. Grab is strong against shield, and shield is strong against attack. It's important to pick a spirit that has an advantage over your opponent.
All right. When you Melia!
Traps like poison floors and slumber floors, be sure to prep yourself with an appropriate support spirit. Battle conditions offer hints before battle, so make sure to read them and form the right strategy.
Well, they're all timed, too. Where's your spirits?
With spirits on your side, there are all kinds of things you can do. When you fight with a primary spirit equipped, it'll level up after battle.
I see.
Or you can feed it snacks. Some spirits even have an enhanced form you can only unlock by leveling them up. You can also send spirits back to the real world. While you do have to say goodbye to that particular spirit, its core will stay. And by combining these cores, you can summon a new spirit.
So they turned it into Fire Emblem Heroes?
Train spirits at dojos and the gym.
Doc Lewis.
Or send them off in search of treasure, which they'll bring.
Oh, so it's...
These seem like unlikely teams of characters, but each team could be somebody's dream.
So it's like a... What'd you call it?
Training playing. And exploring continues to yield...
It's like in Xenoblade 2.
Or after turning off the game. So if you send out your spirits, just let them do their thing.
Cuttlefish. Are known as masters. Captain Toadette. You can beat them to unlock facilities.
Spirits can also be used to power up amiibo figure players.
Mm-hmm. They need to do something, I guess.
You must bid them farewell, but you can repeat the process multiple times. It's one great big collection of characters from many different series, but just how many would you guess there are?
As many as there probably would be trophies.
Whenever you fight against the spirit, the final smash meter is enabled.
Okay.
Some spirits even help you.
Okay, we're finally seeing Yoshi's final. Ah! It's a run of the Yoshis! That's adorable. I like it.
Another way to put it, the spirit system lets you simulate battles between characters from more series than ever before. You can enjoy many unbelievable combinations and situations. The power of enemy and ally spirit teams is displayed here. Of course, stronger spirit teams make it easier to defeat weaker spirits. The more your power overshadows theirs, the less you'll be rewarded. It pays to have a fair fight. While assembling a team, press the Y button for a recommendation that has a type advantage against the opposing spirit team. The game will recommend support spirits who can help out with certain conditions. Keep that in mind.
I'll admit, I'm starting to get a little confused.
You can also fight against other players who are using spirits. Given the way spirit types interact in battle, think carefully when building your team. Or balance your strengths in a two-on-two battle.
It's basically the new custom moves. Local wireless and online.
The game lets you battle together with friends via local wireless, or take the fight to the world with online play. To connect to Nintendo Switch consoles, press the ZR button to pull up the dashboard and select local wireless. There's no longer a need to separate the online modes into for fun or for glory. Instead, matchmaking is based on three factors.
Preferred rule.
For online battles, you can set your preferred rules.
Okay.
These rules can be pre-registered so you can quickly select your favorite playstyle. Before battle, one player's preferred rules will be chosen at random, and all players will fight using those rules. You can also choose not to set any preferred rules and let the others decide.
Interesting.
If possible, the matchmaking system will find players with similar preferences and link them up for a battle.
Global Smash Power is back.
Global Smash Power is being factored into matchmaking, but it's still used as an online leaderboard as well. A high GSP score, such as 100,000, means you've got more points than 99,999.
Cool, I guess.
Your GSP will change as the total population of players increases or you're overtaken. If you're yearning for a challenge, try increasing your global smash power so that you'll naturally end up with some more serious opponents. By the way, you can set a GSP score for each fighter. Fighters you haven't used yet will be assigned a placeholder GSP based on the highest score you've set with one of the other fighters. If you repeatedly self-destruct on purpose, you could face a penalty, like being disconnected, so please don't do that. As with any multiplayer game, a stable connection is very important. For this reason, the matchmaking system will prioritize shorter distances between players. So even if you set your preferred rules, please understand that we can't promise you'll always be matched accordingly.
I see.
As such, we'd appreciate it if you could make your connection.
Recommending the LAN.
A wired LAN cable is recommended. We've prepared a variety of other features for local wireless and online battles.
Elite battles.
Once your global smash power is high enough, you can enter elite battles. When you reach this level, feel free to pat yourself on the back. You're good, period. After the game releases, we may adjust the game balance, and the team will definitely pay attention to the results of these elite battles.
Oh, I see. So it helps to adjust balance.
Everyone who plays online needs their own smash tag. If you beat a fellow player, you'll receive their smash tag.
See.
But it's not like you'll lose your smash tag even if you lose a battle. You simply gain more tags as you win. Try to collect lots of smash tags.
So they're like dog tags, I guess. Short messages.
You can select short
messages. So those are back.
And send them before and after battles using the directional buttons. Freely choose from a wide selection of varied preset messages. After you've chosen a fighter, you can enjoy other modes while you wait for the battle.
I see.
Not every mode will be available while matchmaking runs in the background, but you can leave and enter
some modes. So like you probably can't jump into classic mode.
Spectator mode returns once
again.
Alright,
spectator is back. Good.
Maybe you can pick up some good tips that way. Form a two-player team and play together online with a single Nintendo Switch system. You'll be paired up against two-player teams with the same setup. When you want to play online, you can create a special type of room to fight other players. If you set the rules for one of these battle arenas, you can fight against your friends. Here, there are spots where you can join the battle, wait in line, or even spectate. It all depends where you place your token.
I see.
When you're in a battle arena, this should come in handy.
The online app.
With the Nintendo Switch online app, you can voice chat with others in battle arenas. It may become an essential tool for some players. We are also developing a free service for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and we're naming it Smash World. Instead of focusing on stats like win-loss records, or allowing players to post gameplay videos, watch them, and more, once the service starts, we'll offer regular updates so you can post to your
That doesn't seem too bad, I guess.
Next, I'd like to change topics and talk a little bit about the trophies that will support your fighters in battle. Do you know which characters come from which games?
Are you serious? Oh no. Oh, Yuri. Yuri from Fatal Frame. Ooh. That's weird. Isaac is back as an assist trophy. Black Knight is an assist trophy.
Know your place.
Swamp. Yep. Sound is off. Hang on. Spring Man's an assist trophy? Hi. Wily! Wily's an assist trophy. I mean, I guess. Flies in hand, that's a good assist trophy, I guess. Tiki! I'm kind of okay with that. Who in the world? Vince. That's weird. Guile! Guile! Sonic Booms! Flash Kick. Does he do Sonic Booms? He's gotta do Sonic Booms. Akira! From Virtua Fighter. I'm sorry the sound's a little behind, but I don't know how to fix that.
The total number of assist trophies is now 59. Actually, they outnumber the Pokemon this time.
Assist trophies who can be KO'd can also be defeated by the fighter who summoned them just before they're KO'd. That way, you won't lose a point to the other player. Now, I'd like to cover a variety of other features in the game.
Help.
If you want to review the controls or game modes, press the ZR button to open the dashboard and there are all kinds of helpful guides to check out. Sentry Smash may look familiar to veterans. It feels great to keep
so multi-man smash,
doesn't it? You can play on many different stages.
Okay, so you can play on different stages, so that's cool.
In previous games, you had to unlock every fighter before playing All-Star mode, but now you can play it right out of the box.
You kind of could do that before.
The available fighters will appear endlessly.
I see.
You can save
Alright, so replays are back.
And now, you can create videos with it.
Okay.
There's also a menu where you can read those quick tips and tricks you see during loading screens.
I think there was one like that before, anyway.
When viewing them, you can sort by category or fighter.
Challenges are back. Good.
Complete challenges to earn rewards. This time, each page is sorted by category, and the layout looks more like a comic book. Press the button to check out each picture. Enjoy!
Records.
The records menu tracks your battle history. There are five different
options. I didn't see masterpieces.
You can view battle data separately for offline and online play. Trade in smash tags to score some in-game gold.
So you still get gold. That's cool. The shop.
Gold can be exchanged for music tracks, spirits, and items for spirits.
And outfits. For Mies.
If you're collecting music, I recommend visiting the shop to find the ones you want, instead of just relying on challenges.
Options.
You can enter the options menu by pressing the ZR button to open the dashboard. This one game supports 11 languages. I know this is very important to some of you. For example, the voices of Pokemon are different in several languages. The fighter names are also specific to each language. These options were highly requested and well worth the effort. TV mode and handheld mode have separate settings for brightness and sound. They'll change automatically when you dock and undock.
I'll be honest with you, this is...
We've implemented a radar that displays the location of all fighters. You can change its settings, including size. While it's limited to wireless and online play, you can make your teammates semi-transparent so you don't get distracted. If you're fighting against a friend on the same system, you can adjust the strength of your fighters. Sometimes a player is just too good, and you want to take measures to ensure it's a fair fight. If that's the case, try using this feature. When custom balance is adjusted, a symbol will be displayed. Of course, this feature is not available during wireless and online battles. You can customize your Mii fighters and change their outfits.
Cool.
In addition to the voice options, there are a variety
of we're back.
To choose from.
The voices are back. I think.
Speaking of Mii fighters, let me introduce you to some new outfits we added in.
Breath of the Wild. So Yiga Clan. The Splatoon 2 set. I don't know, those could have been costumes for the Inklings, but okay. Ribbon Girl. Chibi Robo. Ray Mark 3. Labo. The Toy Con. That's funny. What's that behind it, though?
Anyway, there's something I should point out. As I said, we've revealed all of the fighters you can find.
What? Okay.
There are even more coming post-launch. While we've already implemented a huge roster of fighters, this is the Super Smash Bros. Series, which means we're leaving the opportunity open to add in
more
fighters.
Okay, so let me guess. Another ballot?
Since we already included every fighter from the past games, that means there are no more fighters to include unless we develop new fighters from scratch. We're not talking about Echo fighters. We'll be developing and selling sets that will include one fighter, one stage, and multiple music tracks. The price for each set is expected to be $5.99. At the same time, we will offer the Fighter's Pass. That's five fighters, five stages, and all of their music tracks.
Released in 2020.
When creating something like the Fighter's Pass, ideally, we should reveal what's included before it becomes available for purchase. However, please allow us to offer this pass before we're ready to reveal its contents. I hope only those who are...
I mean, I'm sure there will be some good characters.
Again, the price is $24.99 for all five sets. Now that we've finally confirmed the development of this DLC, please know that we'll be...
I hope Geno's one of those characters.
I wonder if I'll ever get to take a break. By the way, here's one purchase bonus you'll get with the fight.
Let me get some spirits.
It's a Mii sword fighter outfit based on Xenoblade Chronicles 2. We decided which fighters to include when we started planning, so we couldn't add characters from titles like Xenoblade Chronicles 2, which was announced after planning had started. I hope this outfit will help you feel like you're playing as Rex.
At least there's that.
Xenoblade Chronicles series. Give it a listen at Gower Plains sometime. Other Xenoblade Chronicles characters will also appear as spirits. We've yet to create any of the paid DLC, and we haven't locked down any release dates, but we'll start working on them as soon as we're finished with the main game. It may take around a year or so to finish releasing all the DLC. But, on a separate note, we're currently developing something. Something you'll get for free as a limited time offer if you buy the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game now. It isn't finished yet, but I want to give you a special sneak peek.
Petey Piranha is a playable character. Oh, a piranha plant as a playable character? He turns it to a PD as a final smash.
That's right. Piranha Plant will take root in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. And not as a trophy, but as an actual fighter. It can spit poison, fire off spiky balls, and perform long range attacks.
Whatever. Sakurai does what he wants, I guess.
Its final smash is Petey Piranha. If you get caught in the cage, well, let's just say it won't end well for you. Piranha Plant is scheduled for completion after the launch of Super Smash Bros. Ultimate.
We've gotten a little head start on it, but it probably won't be ready until a couple of months after launch. Please stay tuned. Remember, Piranha Plant is a free, limited-time offer. For the physical version of the game,
you
need to go through the My Nintendo registration process to
receive. Okay.
I hope you'll consider pre-ordering. We're also creating an amiibo.
Okay.
It has a nice curved form to it. Later today, you'll be able to
Repurchase
the game after finishing this Nintendo Direct. I hope you'll go to Nintendo eShop or Nintendo.com.
It's almost been the 40.
I have an announcement for everyone watching this in North America. On our official site, you can find information for a variety of upcoming hands-on events. Participants will have a chance to try out all 74 fighters, so please check out the website to find out where we'll show up next, and more. That's it for the last Nintendo Direct for Super Smash Bros. Ultimate before the game launches.
What?
But before we go, I should mention that the adventure mode in this game is nothing like what we came up with for the Subspace Emissary. That said, what exactly caused all these characters to lose their bodies and transform into spirits? I'll show you how it all begins and leave the rest to your imagination. Okay then, please look forward to the game's release.
Okay, so we do get a... some sort of adventure mode, I guess.
Don't let a Fox. One get away.
Okay, there's everyone. Hands. What is that?
We'll each need to take down about 10.
Show your fear. It's now or never.
They speak. Uh-oh, Shulk's Monado. Watch out, Link, Samus, Zelda, Mewtwo, Sonic, Pikachu, Bayonetta, Bowser, Falcon, Lucario, Inklings, Falco, Palutena, the Pits. Snake. Diddy. Rosa. Kirby. Is Kirby gonna be okay at least? Black Knight. Everyone. What did the hands do? Of course, Kirby's still okay. Those different worlds? Yes. So it's a whole world map and everything. Flickering through
World of Light. Okay, let me refresh real quick. Hey guys, so I hope you enjoyed the reaction video. I'll talk about my full thoughts in another video, but the long and short of it is Smash Bros. Ultimate is going to be an amazing game. Fantastic. I don't think it can be perfect anymore. I think they missed the ball with it being absolutely perfect. But I'm still going to get it. I'm still excited. This final Direct could have been organized better. Or they could have planned out the announcements and releases better, I should say. World of Light looks awesome. Incineroar and Ken are cool characters, though they shouldn't have been the last ones. Assist trophies, at least they're in the game. Piranha Plant is a weird DLC character, but, I mean, whatever, right? He's free, so I can't complain too much. Online's good. Challenges are good. Century Smash is okay. Or good. Spirits, kind of underwhelming until they announce World of Light. And yeah, that's about the extent of it. Alright. Well, I'll catch you guys in the next one. See you later.